This is the Bible College Wales Lecture Channel, Prayer and Intercession Course. Thank you for joining us today for lecture number 2, The Prayer That Unlocks Heaven. And this is David B. Griffiths, your lecturer today in what is a wonderful course. So anointed. Why is this course so anointed? I'll tell you why. A revelation has come that we are not a praying people. We are people of the Word who pray. That Word entrenched in our hearts, bubbling out from within before the Father. Oh, I tell you, this is way above the vain repetitions. This is anointed of the Lord. You know, when we pray, that innermost being comes out like a volcano. As the lava goes down upon the earth, so the Spirit of God comes down to the natural realm, and we change things through our prayer and our intercession. Let me tell you this. Be crucified to yourself. I'm crucified with Christ, declared Paul. I live, yet not I. I live by the faith of the Son of God. That way, we need not waver or be tossed about. We are the body of Christ, the manifestation of Christ upon this earth, that the words we speak are life unto them that find them. We love you. We bless you. Thank you so much for joining us for lecture number 2, The Prayer That Unlocks Heaven. And yes, within this context, I go to some church fellowships and I sit there and say, I've even heard it said, I just pray for people. I don't know whether the result will manifest or not. I leave it to God. You unstable person. Our faith is established in the Word of Almighty God. In that day, ye shall ask me nothing. John 16, 23 through to 24. In that day, ye shall ask me nothing. Verily, verily, I say unto you, these are the words of the Lord. Whatsoever ye shall ask the Father in my name, he will give it you. What firmer promise is that? Hitherto, you've asked nothing in my name. What does that mean? It means that you've just asked something in your name from your mental capacity. But what you ask in his name is from the inner self, from the inner being. Whatever ye shall ask in my name, ask, and ye shall receive, that your joy may be full. And from Ephesians, giving thanks always for all things unto God and the Father in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. We welcome you to our lecture number 2 of this prayer and intercession course. We give Jesus the praise and all the glory. Download your notes. We're in for an exciting journey today in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Question number 1. The name of Jesus. Again, in that day, join me. Ye shall ask me nothing. Verily, verily, I say unto you, whatsoever, say whatsoever, whatsoever ye shall ask the Father in my name, he will give it you. Hitherto have ye asked nothing in my name. Ask and ye shall receive, that your joy may be full. This is the key. Jesus is our mediator. Jesus is our intercessor. Jesus is our advocate and Lord. And there isn't anywhere in the Bible where it says to pray to Jesus. You know why? You'd be talking to yourself. Amen. That's blasphemy. That's exactly the same charge the religious people placed on Jesus. If we no longer live, because we're word people, not feeling people, natural sight people, who then is left? Always to the Father, in the name of Jesus, as he is, 1 John 4:17, so are we in this world. So to the Father, in the name of Jesus, we can talk to Jesus. Oh, that's all part of the process. But we do not pray to him. We can cast our curse upon him. That's all part of the process. But we do not pray to him. We pray to the Father in the name of Jesus. That is why we read Paul in Ephesians 3:14-15. For this cause I bow my knees unto the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, on whom the whole family in heaven and earth is named. Who is the ye? Just think of that. The whole family, the body of Christ is named. What's our name? Jesus. The whole family in heaven and earth is named. So who is the ye in this case? How does the ye receive such assurance? In that day, ye shall ask me nothing for 20 marks. Then we come to question number 2 on page 3. And this is a wonderful message from the Lord that came through Smith Wigglesworth at the Angelus Temple, the home of Amy Semple McPherson all those years ago. He preached this at the Angelus Temple on the 15th of July, 1927. And this is an awesome word. Repeating again, in that day ye shall ask me nothing. The context, we're workers together with God. And Smith Wigglesworth dealt with the subject of interpretation of tongues. Said this, God has come to visit us. And he has revealed himself unto us. But he wants you to be so ready that nothing that he says will miss. He wants you to build on the foundation truth. Are you ready this morning? He asked. That waiting congregation in Los Angeles. What for? Because God has nothing better than yesterday. Higher has something very important. I'll repeat that. God has something better than yesterday. Higher ground, holier thoughts, more concentrated, clearer ministry. God wants us every day to be in a rising tide. It is a changing of faith. It is an attitude of the Spirit. It is where God rises higher and higher. God wants us to come into the place where we will never look back. God has no room for the man that looks back, thinks back, or acts back. The Holy Ghost wants to get you ready. And we're in the context of the 100% prayer, the prayer that unlocks heaven, and to be in that place of the anointing. We need to be moving in power in the heavenly place, not being tossed about by every wind of doctrine, but being in that place of anointing where we don't keep coming back time after time for prayer. That is unbelief. It's of the devil. What we are is a people of power, of glory, of might. Wigglesworth said, people come with their needs. They ask. They go away still with their needs because they do not faithfully wait to receive what God has promised them. If they ask, they will get it. Many people are missing the highest order. I went to a person who was full of the Spirit, but was all the time saying, glory, glory, glory. I said, you are full of the Holy Ghost, but the Spirit cannot speak because you continually speak. Oh, I've had this lots of time. You go and be involved in a ministry session, come to lay hands, and they're speaking. Well, you've got a barrier to begin. He kept still then, and the Spirit began speaking through him. We are all together in the way of God. Wigglesworth declaring, do more believing and less begging. I want so to change your operation in God. It's what this lecture's all about. We want to change your operation in God till you know that God is operating through you for this time and forevermore. May the Spirit awake us to deep things today. Are you ready? What for? That you may move and be moved by the mighty power of God that cannot be moved and so chastened and built up till you are in the place. Doesn't matter where the wind blows or difficulty comes, you are fixed in God. Are you ready? What for? To come into the plan of the Most High God, believing what the Scripture says and holding fast that which is good, believing so that no man shall take your crown. The Word of God changes the believer. God can so change us by his word that we are altogether different by day. David knew this. He said, thy word hath quickened me. He sent his word and healed me. How beautiful that God can make his word abound. I have hid thy word in my heart that I might not sin against thee. And you know something? Jesus never prayed for the sick once. He never once prayed for the sick. And Wigglesworth continues. We're at the top of page 5. It is absolute infidelity and unbelief to pray about anything in the Word of God. The Word of God has not to be prayed about. The Word of God has to be received. If you then will receive the Word of God, you will always be in a big place. If you pray about the Word of God, and this is what is happening in the emerging church, in charismatic fellowships, they know naught of the Word. They've cut out the preaching for homilies. They've cut out the Bible studies. They've cut out the prayer meetings based on the Word. They've cut all those things out. What you will get is a manifestation of the devil. Wigglesworth said, if you pray about the Word of God, then the devil will be behind the whole thing. Never pray about anything which is a thus saith the Lord. Has to be yours to build you on a new foundation of truth. I want to turn your attention, declared Wigglesworth, to the 6th chapter of the 2nd epistle to the Corinthians. This is a summit position for us. Although there are many ground lines to be examined to see if we are rising to the summit of these glorious experiences, this is also groundwork for deep heart searching. This is revelation, divine revelation of the spiritual character to us. The writer must have been immersed in this holy place. If you turn to the first verse of Romans 12, commonly turned to by Rees Howells at the Bible College of Wales, you will see that the speaker is operated by an operation. He has been mightily under the operation on more than a surgical table. He has been cut to the very depths till he has reached the place absolutely on the altar of full surrender. And out of the depths of it, when he has got there, now he is giving his whole life, as it were, in a nutshell. I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that ye present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. And here in this sixth chapter of 2 Corinthians, we have again a beautiful word, which ought to bring us to a very great place of hearing by the hearing of faith. We then, as workers together with him, it is a collective thought. It is preaching to the whole church in Christ Jesus. Paul has the Corinthians in his mind, because the Corinthian church was the first church amongst the Gentiles, and he was the apostle to the Gentiles. Receive not God's grace in vain. We then, as workers together with him, beseech you also that ye receive not the grace of God in vain. From 2 Corinthians 6 and verse 1. One of the most mighty words in Scripture, declared Smith Wigglesworth. People are getting blessed all the time, having revelation. They go from one point to the other, but do not establish themselves in that thing which God has brought to them. Oh, this is anointed words that came through Smith Wigglesworth. If you do not let your heart be examined when the Lord comes with blessing or correction, if you do not make it a stepping stone, if you do not make it a rising place, then you are receiving the grace of God in vain. People could be built far greater in the Lord and be more wonderfully established if they would move out some things sometimes and think over the graces of the Lord. Grace is to be multiplied on conditions. How? In the first chapter of 2 Timothy, we have these words, the unfeigned faith, that is where is in thee. It is why it is from here that we pray by faith. And everyone in this place, the whole church of God, has the same like precious faith within him. And if you allow this like precious faith to be foremost, utmost on everything, you'll find that grace and peace are multiplied. Just the same. The Lord comes to us with his mercy. And if we do not see that the God of grace and mercy is opening to us the door of mercy and utterances, we are receiving it in vain. I thank God for every meeting. I thank God for every blessing. I thank God every time a person says to me, God bless you, brother. I say, thank you, brother. The Lord bless you. I see it's a very great place to have people desirous that we shall be blessed. If we want strength in building in our spiritual character, we should never forget the blessings. When you are in prayer, remember how near you are to the Lord. The time that God wants you to change, strength there, and he wants you to remember he is with you. So when you open the sacred pages and the light comes right through and you say, oh, isn't that wonderful? Thank God, for it is the grace of God that has opened your understanding. When you come to a meeting like this, the revelation comes right through and you say, oh, isn't that wonderful? Thank God, for it is the grace of God that has opened your understanding. I repeated that. I repeat it again. When we open the sacred pages and the light comes right through, you say, isn't that wonderful? Thank God, it's the grace of God that has opened your understanding. And when you come to a meeting like this, the revelation comes forth. You feel this is what you wanted. Receive it as the grace of the Lord. God has brought you to a place that he might make you a greater blessing. Constant salvation. We're on page 6 towards the end. For he saith, I have heard thee in a time accepted, and in the day of salvation have I succored thee. Behold, now is the accepted time. Behold, now is the day of salvation. From Paul's second epistle to the Corinthians 6:2. Two processes of salvation, declared Wigglesworth. He succored you when the Spirit was moving you, and when the adversary was against you, when your neighbors and friends wished it not to be, when everybody rose up in accusation against you, when you know there were fightings without and fightings within, he succored you. He covered you till you came into salvation, and then he keeps you in the plan of his salvation. This is the day of salvation. Being saved does not mean to say that you were not saved, but that you are being continually changed in the process of regeneration, being made like unto God, being brought into the operation of the Spirit's power, being made like unto him. This is the day of salvation. He has succored thee in a time when Satan would destroy thee, and he is with thee now. This is the day of salvation. If we remain stationary, God has nothing for us. Everybody must see that they must be in progress. Yesterday will not do for today. I must thank God for yesterday. Tomorrow is what I am today. Today, inspiration, divine intuition, where God is ravaging the heart, breaking forth all shorelines, getting my heart only responsive to his cry, where I live and move, honoring and glorifying God in the Spirit. This is the day of visitation of the Lord. This is the great day of salvation being moved into for God. Then interpretation of tongues. It is the Lord. Let him do what seemeth him well. It may be death, but he has life in the midst of death. We will praise and magnify the Lord, for he is worthy to be praised. He has succored us. Now he is building us. Now he is changing us. Now we are in the operation of the Holy Ghost. You must every day make higher ground. You must deny yourself to get on with God. You must refuse everything that is not pure and holy and separate. God wants you pure in heart. He wants your intense desire after holiness. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. All these things shall be added unto you. In perfect harmony, giving no offense in anything, that the ministry be not blamed. 2 Corinthians 6:3. That is lovely. Oh, the church can be built. God will break down opposing things. If you people in Angelus Temple are in a place where you would rather see one person saved here than two people saved at Bethel Temple, then you are altogether wrong, and you need to be saved. If there is anybody here from Bethel Temple, if you'd rather see one person saved in your temple than two people saved in Angelus Temple, then you are still out of order of the Spirit in the line of God. You are strangers to real holy life with God. If your ministry is not to be blamed, how will it not be blamed? You have to live in love. See to it there is never anything comes out of your lips or by your acts which will interfere with the work of the Lord, but rather live in the place where you are helping everybody, lifting everybody, causing everybody to come into perfect harmony. For remember, there is always a blessing where there is harmony. One accord is the keynote of the victory that is going to come to us all the time. And Wigglesworth continues this message, the interpretation of tongues again, halfway down page 8. Being in affliction for the church, halfway down page 9. Possessing your soul in peace at the beginning of page 10. Giving not offense nor causing distress at the end of page 10. Page 12. Being apprehended in Sweden. We know what this is all about. In stripes, imprisonments, in tumults, in labors, in watchings, in fastings. How those first apostles did suffer. In this place of the 100% prayer life, you are prepared for all these attacks. Wigglesworth declared, Sweden is a most remarkable place in many ways. When I was in Sweden, the power of God was upon me. It was there I was apprehended for preaching these wonderful truths, talking about the deep things of God, seeing people healed on every line. The Lutheran churches, yes, and the doctors rose up like an army against me and had special meetings with the king to try to get me out of the country. And at last they succeeded. It was in Sweden I was escorted out with two detectives and two policemen because of the mighty powers of God moving amongst the people in Stockholm. But beloved, it was very lovely. One of the nurses in the king's household came, and she was healed of a leg trouble. I forget whether a broken thigh or a dislocated joint. She went to the king and she said, I have been so wonderfully healed by this man. You know I am walking all right now. Yes, he said, I know everything about him. I know all about him. Tell him to go. I do not want him turned out. If he goes out, he can come back. But if he is turned out, he cannot come back. I thank God I was not turned out. I was escorted out. They went to see the policeman to see if I could have a big meeting in the park on the Whitsuntide Monday. Policemen joined together and they said, there is only one reason that we could refuse him, and it is on this line. If that man puts his hands upon the sick in the great park, it would take 30 more policemen to guard the situation. But if he will promise us that he will not lay his hands upon the people, then we will allow him to use the park. They came and asked me, and I said, promise then, I know God is not subject to my laying hands upon the people. And when the presence of the Lord is there to heal, does not require hands. Faith is the great operation position. When we believe God, all things are easy. So they built places where I could speak to thousands of people. I prayed, Lord, you know, you have never been yet in any place fixed. You have the mind of all things. Show me how it can be done today without the people having hands laid upon them. Show me. To the people I said, All of you that would like the power of God going through you today, healing everything, put your hands up. There was a great crowd of hands. Thousands of hands went up. This is the Abba Father. Lord, show me. And he told me as clearly as anything to pick a person out that stood upon a rock. It was a very rocky place. So I told them all to put their hands down, but this person. To her I said, tell all the people, what are your troubles? She began to relate her troubles. From her head to her feet, she was so in pain that she felt if she did not sit down or lie down, she would never be able to go on. Lift your hands high, I said. Then in the name of Jesus, I rebuke from your head to your feet the evil one. And I believe he has loosed you. And oh, how she danced, how she dumped, and how she shouted. This was the first time that God revealed to me it could be done. We had hundreds healed without touching them, hundreds saved without touching. Our God is a God of mighty power. Oh, how wonderful, how glorious, how fascinating. The message of this, let me tell you, is that you are continuously one in Christ, hearing of the Spirit and hearing from him as a co-worker. You know, when we start considering these testimonies of Smith Wigglesworth, you know the Holy Ghost is no respecter of persons. And he covers, as we come to the next page, the high tide, going through various questions and answers, which you can study for your research, which is about to come, which I ask you to consider very, very carefully. The prayer that unlocks heaven is a prayer that comes from the high place of a person so entrenched with the word of God, pulsating with the Spirit from within. And so we ask you to summarize bottom of page 18 and comment on the comments of Smith Wigglesworth in relation to 100% prayer. We're looking for 1,500 words. We want to see you interact with certain thoughts on this subject. Most importantly, prophetically, what the Spirit is saying to you on what we've been talking about now, on the prayer that unlocks heaven, the 100% success prayer. And as Lindsay comes up to sing this lovely song, the only real peace. I tell you this, the Lord will lift you up as you seek him in those heavenly places in Christ Jesus. The prayer that unlocks heaven, the 100% success prayer. Lindsay, come and sing this lovely song. God bless you.
Thank you, David. This is all about the peace of God, which is the only real peace, the peace of God, which passeth understanding. Jesus said, peace I leave with you, peace I give unto you. I do not give as the world gives. It's my peace, he said. The only real peace.
Life is a few days of trouble, a wise man once said. But I'll not complain, for I'm sheltered, I'm clothed, and I'm fed. But many is the trial, my wants and my dreams put me through. the harder I fall. And sometimes I've wondered if dreams are worth dreaming at all. But my disappointments can't keep me blinded and blue. Not when I'm reminded the sweet peace I have, Lord, in you.
Thank you for joining us today on Prayer and Intercession. Come as students at the Bible College Wales. We'd love to hear from you. Email me at ecctv4219@gmail.com. We thank you for watching Prayer and Intercession, the prayer that unlocks heaven, being in that special place. Hallelujah. Our UK telephone and fax is indeed 01492 544 51, or faxing 01492 540 282, from overseas 0044 1492 544 51, or 0044 1492 540 282. Our student's email is phcc4219@aol.com. Our TV channel email, ecctv4219@gmail.com. This is David and Lindsay Griffiths saying thank you for joining us. You can write to us at the Bible College Wales at Brinley, Colwyn Bay, or rather Colwyn Crescent, Rosonsea, Wales, LL284RG. Thank you so much. God bless you. See you for lecture number 3, The Authority of Jesus' Name. We love you. God bless.